Okay, Aki Kareem for British boxers. We're down here at Collyhurst and Moston Boxing Gym. We've got the main man, Lyndon King Arthur, in the house.
Main man.
Oh, the co-main man, sorry. The co-main man.
Sharon.
Why have you always put your voice in my shit?
I heard main. I thought he was talking about me then. Sorry.
Firstly, I mean, I know we caught up with you after your last fight, Lyndon, but just to, you know, now that you're a week on from it, you probably had a chance to watch it back.
Yeah.
How did you assess your performance last time out?
Yeah, it was good. Again, I was just happy that I got the stoppage against a tough opponent like Remy. I worked behind my jab well. I put a few combinations together well. I threw a lot of punches more than I think I've done in any of my fights. So that's an improvement. It was a good performance.
Something I actually noticed about you. You seemed to be on the front foot a lot earlier. Normally you break down an opponent a little bit more, but you actually walk into this guy.
Yeah, because when I watch him box, I see he's best when he's on his front foot, because he's small and compact. His style, if you let him, is to come forward. So I thought I best put him on his back foot. Not giving him any chance to get any shots off to throw, and it worked well.
Absolutely, and I know you've got very high standards in this gyms, and you guys, you do after a performance, you know, you really analyse where you went wrong and things like that.
Yeah.
But I mean, the camp seemed pretty happy afterwards, didn't they?
Yeah, like I said, the plan was to do something that not a lot of people can do. And that was just to get the stoppage against a person that doesn't really get stopped. I boxed well. I boxed behind my jab to instructions, and I got the stoppage. So, you know, it was a good performance all around. I'm happy.
Okay, and now the dust has settled on the last fight. Of course, we are looking forward to your next one. And there's a big show coming up, Black Flash promotion show on the 29th of July, the Bowlers, which has really been billed. It's been billed as Manchester Young Guns, I think it's been called.
Okay.
And of course, looking ahead to getting on even bigger stages now.
Yeah, that's my sixth to eight rounder. I'm not sure what Pat's got in plan so for me. So I'm just gonna be ready for that. I'm back in the gym, back sparring already. Didn't have really any time off at all. A few days. I only did 3 rounds sparring, so you know, it's not put too much on my body, so I was able to get back in the gym and spar straight away, helping Charlie Schofield for his fight, preparing for his fight, and just trying to stay sharp, really, you know. But I won't get into like hard circuits or anything yet, but you know, just pacing myself along.
Do you actually enjoy being this active then? I mean, I know you're used to the GB squad where you guys are very active, but as a professional, are you quite happy to be out then quite a lot and keeping active?
Yeah, it's good. At the beginning of your professional career, you have to be very active. Like in the 4 to 6 rounds until you start doing 8 and 10s, that's when the training camps get longer and they get tougher and it takes more out of you. So you probably need more rest and stuff like that. But when you're in the beginning of your career doing 4 to 6 rounds, it's probably best to be out as much as you can. It's great to be active. It's great that Pat's got Black Flash promotions to keep us active. Now I've had 6 fights, 29th will be my 7th. I look to move on and be on bigger stages. Yeah. And build my career, some more add to what I'm doing. So yeah, I'm just happy that I'm active fighter is a happy fighter, and right now I'm happy what I'm doing. I'm happy how fast my career is going. I'm just happy.
He's happy. And I still feel like we haven't really seen you out of second gear yet.
Nah,
that's how I sort of feel when I watch you. I think
It's getting to the point where you don't really want to face too many pushovers. Do you know what I mean? Yeah, I suppose I've been stepped up a little bit, not too much, but obviously with the facing Elvis Dube early. It was just before we put a good performance up against Luke Blackledge. The journeyman that I am fighting, I supposed to be, you know, a durable journeyman, and it's not beating a journeyman, because everyone, probably no disrespect to them, can beat them, outbox them, outpoint them, but I'm stopping them, and it's probably a lot harder to stop journeymen than it is to just beat them outbox. So you know, I'm not saying I've not. I feel like I'm ready to step up a little bit, step closer to that little bit of the next level, a bit more of a better opponent.
Yeah, and of course the light heavyweight division is actually becoming quite an impressive division. There's some really good names in there.
It was low for a bit, But now, in England itself, there's a good few. Josh Watts is just turned pro, and Yarde is doing his thing.
What do you make of Anthony Yarde? I was at his last fight, and he looks really impressive.
He's good, man. He's good, isn't he? You can't fault him. He took out someone who had the Southern Area title. Was it played with him? He could have took him out in a round. He worked behind. He knew what he wanted to do when he went in there. He wanted to finish him in body shots. He did that. It was good to do that to someone who's supposedly undefeated. And you know, no disrespect to Chris Hobbs. He just did his thing, man. He's good. I hope he keeps winning. And in the future, that could be a possible a great domestic fight. If I keep winning and he keeps winning again, but Watts is just turned pro. You know, it's getting fiery, and I like it. You know, it keeps me sharp. It keeps the fire going, then it keeps the fire burning.
And as a prize fighter, that must be just exciting for you as well, just you know, the thought of it.
Yeah, of course. Like I said, when you turn pro, you want to be on big stages. You want to fight. Like you see, Kell Brook just fought in front of 27,000 of his fans. You wanna be on them big stages. You wanna be on box office events. You know, you see boxers doing it. England's becoming a massive talent for boxing. A massive talent for boxing right now. It's on fire. It used to be America, now it's England, and to be a part of that is a fantastic thing. You know, but Zelfa, he's fighting for titles soon. You know, so the gym again is, I say it on every interview, the gym's getting back to where it used to be. It's becoming fiery again. Matthew Ryan's got a great opportunity in Ted Cheeseman. English title defense on a Matchroom show. He's getting his name out there to make something for himself. So again, the gym's on the way up. We've got great trainers in Paulie and Pat. You know, we've got a great team, British Boxers TV. You know, everything's going well, so we can't be happy.
Absolutely, man. I think that's a great point to sort of end it there. It's been great chatting to you, and obviously we'll catch up with you before your next fight, but all the best, man. Take care.
Thank you.
Aki Kareem, British Boxers, you know the score. Power.